everyone, my name is Emma and welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another video all about the CRP process. I haven't made a video in a while regarding this stuff because I haven't really been doing much in regards to preparing for the CRP, but yes, today I have some things to update you on, so that's what we're going to talk about in today's video. So I just want to start off by saying thank you to everyone for being so lovely and kind and supportive regarding this whole process, and my friends and family who have been ever so supportive of this adventure I'm about to embark upon, and also like my work colleagues and things like that. Everyone has been super nice about the whole thing and genuinely curious, so I guess maybe some of these videos might give some information to people who are still curious about what I've been up to and what I've been doing behind the scenes just to like get the ball rolling on all of this stuff. Before I start as well, you may have noticed that the quality is different. You may have not, because you know, maybe you don't know, but I'm using a different camera that I already owned, because for those who don't know, I used to do Twitch streaming, so I have a lot of like random tech equipment and stuff, and I completely forgot when I was making all those other videos that I actually had a different camera that I used for streaming that I could potentially use for vlogging as well, because I was finding that in my previous videos I wasn't super happy with the audio quality. So I'm testing this one out today. Hopefully I'm bringing you some better quality videos from here on out. I was using the Canon G7X Mark II. I don't think it's EOS. I don't know what the actual name is. The Canon G7X Mark II. I've had this camera for years. It's kind of like your traditional vlogging camera, whatever. But I actually have a newer camera, the Canon EOS M200, which I did use for streaming, as I said. I think it might be actually better quality. So we're gonna try this one. I can still use this camera for pictures and stuff because it takes the most beautiful pictures. This one has like interchangeable lenses and stuff, so I have some other lenses as well. Yeah, I could always upgrade my setup, and yeah, I'm excited to continue to bring you better quality video. In terms of all the things that I've been up to, there hasn't been heaps, although I have made some really big steps towards my preparations for the CRP. So the first one is that I booked my flight. So yeah, I am ever so grateful because I am going in a group of quite a lot of people. So my intake starts in July, and I guess maybe that's the start of the peak summer season. So I'm really getting thrown in there in the deep end during like one of the busiest times of the year. But what I think that also means is that the people I'm starting with, there's quite a few of us. So we've been talking on Facebook Messenger, and I believe at this point, because I'm trying to remember, there's five girls who are all booked onto the same flight. So we're all gonna be going from the same airport, so we can maybe like sit together and stuff and like get to know each other. And also we are flying on the same flight to the same destination. We don't know yet whether we're going to be able to sit together because we haven't been able to book our seats yet, but I'm hoping like at least some of us can sit together or like in the same vicinity so that we can all go on this little adventure together. That's really exciting. I booked my flight with Aer Lingus. Because of the time of year, it's kind of like expensive to fly. Be completely transparent to anyone who wants to know this stuff. You do have to pay for your own flights. It's not like, I think things like Camp America and stuff, sometimes they pay for your flights. With this, you do have to pay for your own flight. Just got an economy flight from Aer Lingus, and the cost is £700. I think it was 707. It's a little expensive. I've had flights to Florida for cheaper, all dependent on the time of year. So the cost of the flight was £707. So with Aer Lingus, if you actually book through their official website, so not through like third-party websites or through like Skyscanner or whatever, because I do tend to look on Skyscanner to look for cheaper flights, you can do like a deposit option essentially. Well, what you do is you put down a deposit to secure your seat on the flight, and then you can pay off the remainder up to, I think it's like 30 days before or something like that, maybe 60. Yeah, there's like a deadline to pay it off, but it kind of like secures that place, and then the flight doesn't get booked up and things like that. So I paid like 240 something like that, and I have like 400 and something to pay. So you do have to do that in a lump sum. You can't pay it off in dribs and drabs, so I hope to pay that off soon. It's a really good option if you want to like secure the flight and then worry about paying later. So it seems like a really good option. I've also seen some videos of people flying on Aer Lingus and it seems really cool. I've never flown Aer Lingus before. I've flown to Florida via like Virgin, British Airways. Back in the day when I was like a kid, I don't know if anyone remembers First Choice, I flew with them before. So yeah, that is the stuff with the flights, and I guess that's a really big step because all this stuff is like non-refundable. I'm really hoping that nothing changes my date, but I know you can switch flights for a fee, so worst comes to worst, we can sort that out. But yeah, everyone's sort of booked their flights and we're all very much looking forward to seeing each other. We're all flying from Manchester as well, so pretty local to me, like I think it's like an hour and a half drive from where I live, so everything's sort of like coming together really nicely and I'm really excited about that. Also this week as well, I got an email from Yummy Jobs asking me to complete my background check. So just so you know, if you're curious about the steps you need to take with the CRP in terms of once you've been accepted, you do have to do a criminal background check. So it's your typical DBS, it's like Disclosure Barring Service, I think is what it stands for. And this is essentially a criminal background check that you tend to get when you're working with vulnerable people. So you'll find if you're working in a job with children or the elderly that you do tend to do this like criminal background check. Or I suppose if you're working abroad, maybe coming into a different country, they want to check that you're not a criminal or you've not done anything dodgy in your lifetime. Yeah, they want to make sure that you sort of pass their background check and that you're safe to work in Disney. So I've done background checks many times in my roles in the past because I have been working with children since I've been 18. I've been doing summer camps every year since I was 18, pretty much working as activity instructors or childcare, like that sort of thing. So I've done quite a few DBSs in my time, and as the years have gone on, they seem to get easier and easier. And since COVID, a lot of it has gone very digital. So in the past, I think I got my first DBS in about 2014. I did like a volunteer trip and it took a really long time, and we had to like physically bring in our documents and then someone had to verify them. We had to send off like forms and stuff. And then as I went into other jobs, it got a little bit easier. You still have to like bring in and prove that you have your like identification physically. Like a lot of the time I had to bring the actual passport to my employer. But what I found recently is that they have this app, the government have an app, and it works with passports because they have, I guess, like an RFID thing. I really don't know how it works, but if you have an iPhone, you're able to put your phone onto your passport. It like kind of scans the RFID and verifies that it's a real document, and then you sort of scan the passport, scan your face, and it's able to do it all online, which I think is amazing. And the world has really progressed over the years and it just makes that step really simple. So yeah, you do get a online certificate which is just as valid as the paper one. So you get sent a paper one in the mail, I believe, but you also get the one online, and that is just a really cool thing. Like I'm very impressed with how the DBS has like progressed since I first started getting them. So yeah, they're really simple to get, and there is a £18 fee. Wasn't sure whether this was paid for by Yummy Jobs or Disney, so I had to double check before I paid for it because I didn't want to be out of pocket for something that I didn't have to pay for. But yeah, apparently you do have to pay for the £18 criminal background check. I went and looked on the Yummy Jobs website and they don't actually list this as a cost. So just to make you guys aware, there is an £18 cost to do your criminal background check. So just factor that into your budget if maybe you didn't expect it, because I wasn't sure myself whether we had to pay for it or whether it was like covered, just because with previous employers it has been covered for me. So yeah, you just have to double check that. You then basically follow the instructions on the Yummy Jobs email that tells you to share, like there's a share code that you can get on the DBS like website, on the government website, where you can get a code, and then that allows Yummy Jobs to access your certificate because it's all very secure. You know, there could be sensitive information on there. While my DBS just says nothing on it, some people may have convictions, I don't know, or like things like that. So I guess it's quite private information, so it has to go through like certain levels of security. And so there is like a password, it's like a one-time viewing word sort of thing. So you send that to Yummy Jobs and that allows them to view it. So I haven't received any more information on that personally, but hopefully they'll give me a thumbs up and say everything's okay. And then they also just sent some information about the visa process, which I think is gonna happen about 3 months before I go out. So by my calculations, it should be around April time. So it's not far really. I know it's the end of January, it's almost February now. So that's gonna fly by and it's gonna be April in no time and I'm gonna be doing my visa. And from what I've heard with that, you can apply online, but a lot of people do get rejected online and then they have to go in physically. So I think it's just like a case of just praying and hoping that you can do it the easy way and have it all done online. Otherwise you have to arrange to get out to London and physically go to the embassy. Thankfully, I actually have some experience of the embassies. I haven't physically gone myself, but I went with my sister to the embassy, the US embassy, because she went and worked in Florida on the Universal like Lowe's program as a lifeguard quite a few years ago now, like it was in 2018. But I went with her to the embassy, waited outside, and then she sort of like explained the process to me and how like it's not scary at all, and it's just kind of like they just need to see you in person to verify some stuff and some documents and ask you a few questions because you're not doing anything dodgy, and it's literally just like, hey, I'm on a work abroad program, here's my passport, can I have a visa? They're like used to that stuff, so yeah, I'm pretty sure they're okay with it. So they give me some information on that, and so I will update on the visa process as and when that happens. So other things, other exciting things. So I have a parcel due today and it has not come yet, so we'll probably add to the end of this video unboxing or with an unboxing of something exciting. So let me show you something. This is my current cabin suitcase that I own. It's by Sharper Image. I got it from TK Maxx for like 50 quid and it is the loveliest green suitcase. Like it's pastel green, it's lovely. And I've been thinking hard about the sort of things I want to bring with me to Florida in terms of like luggage and stuff, and I think I'm gonna need like two bags. If I'm being realistic, I really don't think I'm gonna be able to go to Disney with just one suitcase. I like my comforts and my things and my clothes, so I feel like I'm gonna add an additional suitcase and have two big suitcases. A cabin suitcase is also included in my flight, so thankfully I can bring this. So I'm probably gonna bring this and just pack like a change of clothes or just stuff that I need like within whatever hotel I stay in before I end up going and moving to Flamingo Crossings. Like I'll try and pack essentially what I'm gonna be using in here for the first few days, and then my suitcases can purely just be left alone and open once I move into Flamingo. So I've got this suitcase, it is lovely quality, but I have ordered two new suitcases from the same company that my old suitcase is from. I think it's Luggage or IT Luggage or whatever, and they're coming today, and they are essentially a very similar color to this. Online it looks the same. I feel like in real life it might not be a perfect exact match, but yeah, I'm gonna get two lovely green suitcases kind of in this hard shell style, and I will show you what they look like when they come because I'm very excited. But yeah, the suitcase I have has fallen to pieces, so I definitely needed to invest in some more, so thankfully they're not too expensive. But yeah, I think it's kind of exciting. Like I love getting new travel stuff, so I'm excited to show you that. But yeah, this is the one that I have at the moment, and that's pretty much all my updates really. So when I will see you again in this vlog, I will hopefully have my two suitcases to show off. So many things have happened since I filmed the clips earlier, and yeah, you can see my camera in the mirror now. This is what it looks like. It's like a very pretty white camera. I got this strap in the mail from Amazon. It's like a padded like neck strap so I can carry my camera around and not worry about dropping it. So yeah, you can sort of see. That's pretty cool, so I'm really excited about that. I got a brand new phone grip as well for my phone because I have to use a pop socket because of my small hands, and I love it. It's a golden retriever, it's one of my favorites. And of course, the thing you will be waiting for, I did not unbox it on camera because I got way too excited. I'm a bit of a child in that way, but my suitcases are here. I didn't get like massive ones. I didn't get absolutely ginormous ones because these go really wide. So I wanted to like have ones that wouldn't be over the weight limit. I wouldn't have to worry about it because there's no point in having a ginormous suitcase if it's like way over the weight limit. So yeah, this is my current one, like I said. And then these are a very similar green. They're not a perfect match because they're not the same brand, but I feel like they're very close and I think they look really pretty. So yeah, they're from it luggage, as I said, and they have like the TSA lock, so that's really good for, you know, so they don't break your suitcase, essentially. Ignore all the rubbish everywhere. I've been tidying and I got too excited. I had to show you guys. So yeah, it's like a hard shell case. It's expandable to quite a large size. And yeah, I just think it's really great. I'll open it up just to show you. But thank you for enjoying this video so far. Move my lens cap out the way. Move all this out the way. Yeah, it's just a really big, spacious suitcase. And yeah, it's even got like little pockets to put all my bits and bobs in, so it's just perfect, honestly. I love it. I'm really excited. So thank you all so much for watching. Let me go back to the mirror, ignore all the mess. She's been editing down there on my laptop. I've had such a good day today getting all these fun bits and bobs, and I cannot wait to see you all in the very next video. See you soon. Bye.